All right, we're here with Heather Smith from BarrelRacingTips.com today, and you have a website and a book series that really talks about the foundation of starting a horse and getting him in the barrel racing and what kind of drills and so forth to get the most out of your horse and have the most success with it, right?
Yeah, absolutely. My goal is really to help barrel racers develop horses that are confident and that are educated and that are really prepared to go to the highest levels. And the foundation that we develop in our horses only has to be as deep, as high as we want to go. So it becomes even more critical the higher our goals are. And that goes for our horses, like mentally, and emotionally and physically. And so I think that we really need to have a combination that offers all three of those things and supports a foundation. It's just like, I compare it to planting a fence post. Like, it's only going to be as strong as the foundation is deep. So
very cool. So what's kind of your first starting block to build that foundation?
Well, I think one of the most important elements is for a person to develop is actually reading the horse. It's being able to develop the ability to see the truth behind what's actually going on. And that way we will always be prepared to be able to troubleshoot whatever is happening, because it's not so much about fixing symptoms. There's always some underlying layers there that need to be addressed if we want to create a solution or develop an education that really stands strong on its own and isn't dependent on anything artificial. And again, I think that's where also silver lining comes in, because it helps create this foundation of health that stands on its own and helps the horse really operate at their maximum potential on their own. You know, it supports them to be healthy and to be at their very best, just as they are, without a whole lot of artificial, you know, ingredients and so forth that ultimately can end up harming our horses in the long run.
Yeah, you bet. So you said exactly right. I mean, the same foundation that you have in getting these horses started the proper way is the same thing that we try to do, is make sure we're giving them what they need, when they need it, and not doing the extra stuff, because that's when we can kind of pollute them or make it more complicated than it needs to be.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Whether it's our horse's biomechanics and how they're operating, you know, how they're using their bodies in a turn, or how their bodies are functioning to create like the perfect, you know, digestive system, or the perfect environment that supports healthy joints and so forth. And so when we take away and stop doing things that are interfering, then the horse will be able to have this natural balance and natural athleticism and natural health that they were designed to have. And in the process, we'll end up actually, they'll be healthier, they'll be happier, and they'll last longer, they'll be sound, they'll be healthy, and they'll ultimately perform better and achieve more and help us achieve our goals that we have with them.
Yeah, absolutely. So earlier we were talking when you first got into our booth about you're really a student of the game, it seems like. You made a comment about watching the rodeo these last few days and just watching people's timing and so forth. And you said how great like Sherry Servey is at her timing. Like, tell me like what you're watching when you're watching the NFR, trying to pick up things for yourself to make you and your horses better.
Yeah, one thing that was really interesting is, I really admire Sherry Servey, especially for her consistency over the years. I think that just speaks volumes for her as an individual. And all the different horses that she's had, it speaks volumes for her family's breeding program and for the, you know, the companies like Silver Lining that she works with, of course. But it was really amazing to see her get on a couple different horses and to see the absolutely impeccable timing, like the athleticism and the quickness that it takes for the barrel racers. It's really easy for that to be understated, or people don't always appreciate what that really takes and how fast that needs to be. Like, they make it look so easy. But it's really fun to pick up on those little details and just be inspired and just be basically educated by everything, you know, what they're offering for us every night when they run down the alley.
Very cool. So how do people find you and get a hold of you?
Okay, well, my website again is barrelracingtips.com, and I have a book series, and I'll be coming out with volume 3 hopefully in the next year with more barrel racing exercises. And I'm also on Facebook, so it's facebook.com/barrelracingtips.
Well, very good. Thanks for joining us today, Heather. We're glad to have you a part of the team. I've sure learned a lot from you. Really am inspired when I go to your Facebook and your website. And if you ever have any questions, look up Heather. She's very good about connecting and replying to people's comments. And Yeah, love having you on the team. Appreciate you being here today.
Well, thanks so much for having me. I appreciate everything you do.
Thanks.